This game, Mirovic shot the three-point shot really well here in the semi-final. It's great to have a player who can step out to that range when they're one of your bigs.
Yeah, Carly Mirovic can shoot that three-ball really well. She, she'll be ready to redeem herself after last week's shooting performance, but, you know, she's been capable of it all season, and, yeah, I expect her to come out really confident today and knock down some of those threes.
Okay, so there'll be a few nerves ticking over with the girls right now. They're just about to get underway. Tip-off is almost with us. And like we said, there's loads of firepower across both of the lineups. Who is going to get it done tonight? Who is going to shoot the ball the best? Who is going to be in control of the ball, not turn it over too often? How's the defense going to go? All these questions are going to be asked for you very shortly as the referees put the ball in the air and Perth get first possession. This is Mirovic at the top, back to Lovay. Straight inside to Laney. Good defense from Townsville though to shut her down.
Great job, Townsville, on the transition basket. Foul.
Good start there for Townsville. A good defensive stop, get away on the break. And we have Mia Murray heading off to the free throw line. Mia was a bit, didn't score too well in Perth the other night. An opportunity to get yourself on the board at the free throw line is a great place to get underway.
Absolutely, and she was the grand final MVP last year. You know, she's well and truly capable of a great game, so hopefully she can keep going the way she started.
There's a bit of smoke here in this stadium. You may not be able to see it on your screens, but there were fireworks for the introduction of the Fire players before the game. So a little bit hazy in here, but Mia knocks down the second of her two free throws. That's Michaela Cox now, up close. Perth now going through their offensive sets, getting their structures right. Wickham, great athlete as well. Good penetration, but good help defense cross court. And there it is, it's Mirovic with Perth.
It's a great start for her, bit of confidence, and it'll have her rolling early.
This is Natalie Novosel looking inside. Kayla George.
Great cut there by Susie.
And that cut opened up that three-point opportunity.
Absolutely, Mia Murray.
Laney, pull-up jumper, a little bit long.
Great tip there by Nat Burton on that rebound. That was a very smart play.
We got Tessa LeVay heading off to the free throw line now for a couple of shots. So both teams getting away to a reasonable start?
Yeah, they are. I think, you know, obviously a couple of nerves, but some good plays both ends of the floor so far. Levy makes the first.
And the second, nice touch.
Let's see what Perth do here. They've got their full court defense set up.
Good passing out of the press there from Townsville. Gives them an opportunity at the other end. It's Kayla George in the short corner. It's a little bit long. And it's the Perth Lynx on the way back through LeVay. Levy there, penetrating, pulls up for the jump shot. Just rims in and out, and this time Townsville grab the defensive board. Great work from Laney. Strong anticipation to the penetration to the basket, but comes up with a miss.
Susie's there for the rebound, and off she goes.
George back to
Abakovic.
Both teams there missing a couple of good opportunities on those last two options.
They're both pushing the ball really well early in this game.
The two bigs there working together on high-low post options, but the pass is just a little long over the end line, and the Fire get possession. Shot. 2 points apiece at the moment. There's Novosel looking for an option. Bakovic going to work. Kayla George from out downtown knocks down the big triple. Said before that Kayla needed to score a little more tonight, and right on cue, she makes a big one.
Absolutely, and that's big for Kayla. She's a confidence player, and she'll be feeling it now, which is great for Townsville.
Sammy Wickham controlling the ball. One of the key players for the Lynx as well. She pulls up for the triple. Just a little bit short and wide, and straight away, Mia Murray is off down court. She takes the pull-up jumper. Foul from behind as Batkovic runs the floor and grabs that offensive rebound. Perth going to the bench. We've got some changes coming in. Benaja Laney takes a break.
And Luella Tomlinson comes in, which is, one big girl for the other. So it's going to be good to see Lou get out there and work hard against those two big Townsville girls.
In the game nice and early, so the coach making sure first up he gets his people involved. There's nothing worse than sitting down the end of the bench for an entire quarter.
Well, that's right, and they go deep, so it's great to see them rotating early.
Yep. Bakovic makes the second. And the fire straight up into some full court pressure, or token full court pressure, really. It's not a trap, or just making sure that Perth uses up some time on that shot clock. Levy looking inside for an option. This is Novosel now, pushing down court. Bakovic trying to make position for that inside pass, working hard. The defense is there, putting plenty of pressure on it. So Cox just pulls it back up, looks for the on-ball screen. Back out to Kayla George. Can she do it again? Nah, short and wide. Perth now pushing it straight back down the court. Both teams looking to be aggressive in the transition. That's Natalie Burton knocking down the two. Back down the other court, end of the court. This is going to play. These girls are going to be worn out by the time this is done, Abby.
They are. Their transition defense needs to improve a little bit, both teams here at the moment.
Again, Townsville doing a much better job on the defensive glass than they did here in the semi-final against Perth. Gives you these options, in, out, rims around.
And off Perth go. Good to see Susie back.
The Townsville back in numbers, so Perth just looking to work it now, get their offensive structures underway. This is Levy. Whitcomb coming off the screen, kicks it back out. Three-point attempt is short, and Townsville once again cleaning up on the defensive glass. Perth just not having the opportunity to get any second efforts there just yet.
They're not, and it's tough against, Susie and Kayla, but they need to get in there and box out and get amongst it.
Perth working their way through. Whitcomb now. Goes baseline. Cox is there. So too is Bakovic. What a great shot.
I love to see that, attacking the basket. Perth relies so much on their outside game, but when they attack like that, it's hard to guard.
Michaela Cox returns the favour. She's fouled, and she's off to the free throw line.
Carly Mijovic coming back in here for Nat Burton, giving her a rest, and Darcy Garbin giving Susie Bakovic a rest too. So two big girls in and two big girls out for both teams.
Garbin's been playing some good ball for Townsville, of what I've seen of her.
She has. She's a young kid and she's improved so much since she's been here. Obviously, she played for Perth last season, but yeah, she seems to have improved a lot since being here in Townsville, learning from Susie and Kayla.
Yeah, I guess if you get to go and match up against those girls every week of practice, you're going to learn.
That's right. It's only going to make you better.
A couple of rim rockers, both of them went down. Midway through the first quarter, and it's 12 points to the Fire, 8 to the Perth Lynx. Michaela Cox again. Another player that can light it up from downtown if she gets the opportunity. A poor pass there, but Mia Murray did just enough to recover the possession. We have 12 seconds still remaining on the shot clock. As Novosel goes to work, spins, and just really got into all sorts of trouble, but the foul in the end kind of bailed her out.
Yeah, absolutely. There were three Perth girls around her, and she got bailed out there.
At the end of the day, though, she walks to the free throw line for another two shots. There's a replay. Probably the player from behind just coming over the top. Down goes another two from the free throw line. Change again for the Perth Lynx. This time it's Levy goes for a break, and it's Sammy Whitcomb back into the game. So Townsville just getting a bit of an edge at the start, Abby, but really it's up and down.
Yeah, that's right. 6 points early on. Townsville obviously controlling the momentum at the moment, but I expect something to happen here from Perth shortly.
And backcourt violation forced by some defensive pressure from the Fire.
Townsville's defense has been really good so far. They're really up and pressuring and very energized, which is great to see.
And speaking of energy, if you can hear that crowd in the background, some of that energy will be coming from what these people will help to lift this the team on their home court tonight. Mia Murray, plenty of pressure from Laney. This is George in the corner again, turns and shoots. And again, it's a little off the mark, so Whitcomb gets to bring it back for Perth. Again, pushing it up court, get the Fire back in numbers. Kayla George got a hand in there, but it went back to Whitcomb. She goes cross-court with the pass. And that is just a beautiful shot from Carly Mirovich.
That's her scout, Mirovich. You know, Townsville have got to probably get a little bit of a hand out there. They don't want her getting too hot too early, but a great shot from Mirovich, shooting that confidently.
Well, Kayla George has just gone for a sit-down, so is Mia Murray, and that girl we talked about earlier, Sherry Gallagher, is out on the floor, so we'll see if she lives up to some of my expectations. I'm sure she will. Susie penetrating to the basket. No foul on the play. Good defense from Perth, and it's Laney pushing it back down court. This is Whitcomb. Comes off the on ball. Nothing on. Looking at her bigs inside. Where are the options? Take it to the rack. That's not a bad option. A little off the mark, and straight away, Towns are looking to push down court. This is Michaela Cox. Has Novacell to her left. She goes baseline. Beautiful reverse layup.
Tough finish there by Novacell. Way to attack the basket and then get that finish.
14-11. 16-11. Sorry, the score just ticks over. So it's a five-point game. Townsville leading at the moment. 3 minutes to go as we approach the first quarter break. Whitcomb, again, aggressive. And that's how you draw fouls as well. And fouls will have some impact on this game as we go along. Sherry Gallagher that picked up the foul. If we look at this replay, Abby.
Yeah, she just needed to slide over a little bit. But as you can see, Townsville are switching the on-ball screens like they did last week, which, you know, is good for them, especially because their bigs are mobile. So
plenty of pressure on the inbounds pass, but a good execution there from Perth to get Natalie Burton that little lob so close to the ring.
Yeah, great pass and great finish by Burton inside.
Kayla Cox just exploring, nothing on, pulls it back out. Darcy Garvin takes it back around to Gallagher. Novacell again. Garvin goes from downtown. Looked a chance for a moment. Susie Batkovich in there contesting, but Perth clean up the defensive glass. This is Whitcomb again, penetrating, goes to the rack. Great play from Whitcomb.
Yeah, Whitcomb's really attacking this game, and I love to see it. You know, she's getting a few buckets in there and also drawing a lot of attention and kicking out as well.
And she's got plenty of people who know how to shoot the damn thing, so go looking for them while you're on the way in as well. Novacell inside. Does well. Again, both teams being very aggressive.
Yeah, it's good to see that they're not both settling for that outside shot, and obviously at the moment it's working by attacking the paint and getting some fouls called.
So we take another look. Good strong play. Two shots to come. Townsville up by one. Everything we expected. I watched this. I didn't get to watch the game last week, but I saw the live scores coming through. And these two teams just went head to head for the whole game until Townsville able to break it away in that final quarter. Well, perhaps our score graphic might be wrong. It's 16-13. Just checking that score. No. Maybe that's not slow. The stats are slow updating, that's all. Yep, so the score is 17-15. Here's Mia Murray, has the assignment with Whitcomb.
You can see a mid ball screen here, and the Townsville have switched once again. Whitcomb with the pull-up three, and Darcy Garvin with that big rebound there.
So it's kind of inviting them to step back and take that big shot, but if it's not going down, Townsville are cleaning up on the defensive glass, so it's really only giving Perth that one opportunity.
Absolutely, and you can see the difference from when they attack the basket to when they settle from that for that outside shot.
So Garvin goes to the free throw line. Team fouls for Perth. They have five for the quarter. Townsville! Quick pass down court. This is Burton. Across to Whitcomb. She has Laney there on her left. Again, another very good athlete. I love the jump shot from this girl. A little off the mark, but a great athlete. Sherry Gallagher looks inside. Cross court to Murray, another athlete. Takes it in. Good kick out. Batkovic had a look at it. Again, she goes back inside. 2 points for Susie Batkovic.
Tough finish there by Susie, but you know, that's what she does really, really well. That left-hand finish, she can pretty much make anything.
Ooh. Wow. I thought that was pretty good defense on that play.
From this angle.
So did the crowd.
Let's have a look. Much.
Well, the fire coach was asking for a travel call on that. The feet were kind of all over the place, but referees are kind of watching for the contact as well. It's a bit hard to see all.
Yeah.
Some of the locals getting a little bit upset, but that's what they do. That's their job over in the corner there, is to get on the ref.
Absolutely.
It's Chris Lucas just having a quick sip of water. Throats will go dry for the coaches tonight, trying to get a message out to the floor in this noise. Benaja Laney, it is at the free throw line. She's knocked down the first. Gallagher in court, double team on Cox. She goes downtown with a long pass, and this is good pressure from Perth.
Yeah, great pressure there from Perth. Made Townsville choke that up, and they get the side ball possession. So let's see what they can do here.
Kunirovic, Levy, quick spin move. But Cox was up to the task, still going, still aggressive. A little short on the shot, and it's Michaela Cox now taking off down court for the Fire. Again, plenty of red shirts back there to the Fire retreat. Batkovic has Mia Murray. Murray goes inside. Tough shot, good defense again from Perth. This is Whitcomb now, straight to Laney. She goes to the rack. Got herself into some trouble, but recovers. Whitcomb, good quick crossover. Batkovic sweeps the glass. This is Cox, inside to Batkovic. Tough shot, good second effort on the rebound from Batkovic. Misses again. Wow, this is just, this is up and down. These girls are really, really going hard at
it. It is up and down, and they're gonna have a little breather here and set something up, Perth.
16 seconds on the shot clock.
2 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock here.
Whitcomb inside, little finger roll, doesn't happen. Levy gets another opportunity, ooh, fades away. Off balance with a tough shot and just comes up with a miss. It's quarter time here in Townsville. It is 20 points to 17 and it is the Fire holding sway by that 3 point margin.
There's a lot to take care of. There's the meetings, the deadlines, the phone call you promised your mother, your gym bag full of wishful thinking, and your two-hour park in a one-hour space. But up here, everything's taken care of.
Shiraz or Riesling, sir?
Especially you.
Shiraz, please.
With food, checked baggage, and entertainment now complimentary on Virgin Australia domestic flights.
For my heart.
Whether it's my game or my health cover, confidence is key. And knowing that Queensland Country Health Fund has added and improved benefits for the past 5 years gives me confidence that they're ahead of the game. And my health and fitness is covered. And that's why I switched. Hey Kelly, your shot.
Thanks, Laura.
And Queensland Country makes switching easy. in person, online, or on the phone. So stay healthy, be confident, and switch to Queensland Country Health Fund today.
I choose to be at the top of my game. I choose to be strong, fit, and ready for anything. I lead a fast life, and I choose to keep up. I choose to eat in. And I choose to do things my way. Choose your destiny.
Right, back to the action here at RSL Stadium in Townsville. This is the start of the second quarter, if you've just joined us, in Game 2 of the Wattle Valley Grand Final Series between the Perth Lynx and the Townsville Fire. Townsville up by 3 at the moment, and it's just taking a look through the stats there. Abby, what do you see?
Yeah, look, Susie's got 5 rebounds at quarter time, so that's huge for them. And also, you know, Kayla hasn't got any, which is a big difference to what's normally happening. But expect that to turn around real quick, but Susie's been in there grabbing them all so far for Townsville.
Well, it's Perth in possession right now. This is Mirovic. Laney.
Great defense there by Mia.
Looking for an inside option. Kayla is there, just a little off balance. She goes baseline. Good move. That's and a quick move past Laney for a two-pointer.
Yeah, great poise by Kayla. Just kept her composure and got the finish there and underneath.
Levy now. This is Whitcomb. Laney. Burton stepping out. Oh, good move again from Whitcomb. She is a terrific guard. I like the way she takes that thing to the rack. Good moves to finish off with. This is Novosel now for the Fire. Bakovic at the high post. Kayla George looking for an inside option. Goes back to Susie. Kicks it out. Mia Murray with an option from the three-point line and buries a big one.
Great shot there by Mia and a great penetration by Susie to bring the defender in and then dish it out to Mia.
This is Levy. Laney now at the top of the keyway. Has a long ball. Spins. Good defense again from Murray. Another defensive rebound, this time from Gallagher. Perth just getting that one option so far. Still not able to get themselves into that, the offensive glass. Sherry Gallagher, another one, just rims out off the edge.
Great cut to the basket, though.
Mirovic from downtown. This time, Perth get that second option. Plenty of ball movement. Not sure why Laney didn't take that shot right under the rim. Probably gets herself to the free throw line at the least. Bakovic down the end.
And then Townsville, you know, punish Perth for that one and get a big transition basket there.
So 27-19 is the scoreline. Townsville getting the best of things at the start of this second quarter. Perth need to respond just to make sure they keep this game on an even keel. Three-point shot in and out, but there's Whitcomb with a very good offensive rebound. Good read on the play. Mirovic goes inside past Newley. Sorry, Murray. She is married these days. Turnover there. Good work from the Fire and a quick foul from Mia Murray.
That was a great foul by Mia. Very, very smart, actually, just to stop Perth from getting that quick basket there while her teammates weren't actually back.
Michaela Cox is back in as Sherry Gallagher sits down. Gallagher again, another fine contribution coming off the bench. Perth in possession. Kayla George almost got a hand on that one.
Kayla having a little giggle there. Great pass.
That is a big, big shot from LeVay.
It is a big shot from Levy, and she's yelling at her teammates to get back there on defense. They want to use this as a little bit of a momentum.
Right, Michaela Cox. Kayla George looking inside. Finds Mia Murray back this time to Bakovic. She powers her way to the basket, trying to steamroll the defense out of the way.
She just makes it look easy, Susie. You know, that left-hand move, but such a sweet move and an easy finish.
Well, everyone knows she knows she goes left, but it's another thing altogether to stop it.
Absolutely. I've played against her many times, and it's much easier said than done to stop that girl.
And another rebound beside her name too. We'll keep an eye on some of those counts for the individuals, for the players as we go through. Oh, entry pass inside Kayla. The Fire got lucky on that play, but a missed shot from Kayla. And it's Levy bringing it back, looking for her options. Tomlinson. Again, good penetration play, but the defense was up to the mark. And a nice inside play. This time it was Luella Tomlinson.
Yeah, good to see Luella roll down to the basket there. When Townsville switched that on-ball screen, Luella had the guard on her.
So a quick mismatch as Mia Murray pulls up for another triple. When she gets hot, she can really get on a roll.
Yeah, she's making that look easy too. Great to see Mia making those threes.
So Sid, as you said earlier, grand final MVP when the Fire took it out last year in one game. As we look at, again, good defensive pressure from Townsville. Perth recover.
Novosel's everywhere at the moment. Her defensive pressure is giving Townsville that energy. And here's Cox.
Oh! Hey, momentum, isn't it? You pull up, you take the three, you know it's going to get the crowd really boiling, and they're on their feet around behind us, so they're
absolutely
going off.
Absolutely, and look at Townsville's energy right now. That all came from Natalie Novosel's defensive pressure.
Let's have a look at this one.
Here she is.
Good work and good read. Look, found the open player. Michaela pulls the trigger and gets the friendly rim rocker. The crowd were riding that one home.
Absolutely.
Okay, what are your thoughts? Second quarter, Abby, you know, the Fire really come out of the blocks here. 35-26, a 9-point lead in a game like a grand final is a nice little break for them.
Yeah, look, it is, but it's also at the same time, it's only three baskets, difference. So it's one of those things that it is a nice little buffer to have. Townsville obviously going to try and push forward on that, and Perth are just going to try and chip that back a little bit. But like I said, it's three baskets. It's really not that much in the scheme of things. And I expect Perth to probably get a little bit of a rocket here, and they'll come out a little bit more energised and ready to go.
Of course, the worst thing you can do is try and get it back in a hurry.
Yeah, that's right.
Work your way back in by halftime. You want to be on level terms, or if you can get yourself a little bit in front when you're chasing like this.
That's right. You set your little goals. You say you want to get a couple of stops here, a basket here, and you want to have it by 2 points or level at halftime. And I'm sure that's what they've all kind of agreed on here.
And down the other end, Chris Lucas, what do you think he might have had to say to his girls right now?
I think he's really happy with how they're going. Their defensive pressure has been top-notch so far, and I'm sure he's going to be encouraging them to continue that. So we're going to see here right now with this defensive play. It looks like they're in a zone, maybe.
Yep, good on-ball pressure, though, on the shot there from Kayla George. She's a tall girl. She's got those long arms, and just made it that little bit harder for Laney to shoot over the top. This is Cox now calling the plays. Novosel. Some pressure in the passing lanes from Perth, but just not coming up with the possession. But this is the easy way to get it, a travel call.
Yeah, a little shuffle of the feet there by Novosel.
So a stop for Perth. This is Levy. Laney now, looking for an option. Lots of crossovers. Found a way to the basket this time. Good, strong play, and Bakovic forced a foul.
Yeah, that's what we need to see from Banaja Laney there, attacking the basket and taking on those big girls. She's got 2 points so far, and, you know, they really need her to step up and contribute a little bit more, so hopefully this can get her confidence up.
No foul trouble for anybody there at this point. No one has rucked up anything, so coaches are not pulling players to sit them down, and it's probably not going to impact on the game so much if we don't see too many fouls in that first half.
No, that's right. We don't have anybody really in any foul trouble, so we've got all the big guns out there still.
And good officiating too with the refereeing. You know, you don't want to overcall the game, and they seem to be getting a pretty good match or a mix of what they're pulling up and what they're not. Michaela Cox.
That was Susie's seventh rebound just there.
Seven.
So
wow.
She's grabbing them in.
Novosel. She's got that unusual looking shot, but it is effective. Not on this occasion. Levy looks down court to see what options she has. And that was a quick whack in the back of the ear from, from Novosel. There wasn't much doubt about that one being a foul.
No, that's right. She had the right intention being up there on the defensive pressure.
Wickham, another on ball. Murray turns it back inside, and there's Bakovic sitting and waiting. Just knocks that one away. Coughs inside. Novosel brings it back out. This is Bakovic. Puts it on the floor. Looks for the return pass to get onto that favoured left hand of hers. Oh, she went the other way, but she made the shot just nonetheless. Laney looking for an option. Murray sacrificing the foul as Burton was left unmarked under the basket.
Another smart foul by Mia Murray there, her second one of the game, just intentionally fouling there to stop the 2 points.
So Kayla George sits down. She's had a fine game so far. Not as many rebounds as we're used to from her, but her defense around the, on the bigs from Perth has certainly been of high quality. Natalie Burton misses the first, and the crowd let her know she is away from home. You might be able to hear bells ringing in the background. They all have little cowbells here in the crowd, and it's one of the things that they do. And then that was just a super play from Laney. Bakovic got caught out there, and I don't know if she even knew she had pressure behind her.
No, that was a great rebound there by Laney. Obviously, she's very, very athletic, so she just jumped over the back and grabbed that and put it back in.
Kayla Cox has two. Quick response. Levy. Whitcomb again gets the on ball. This is Tomlinson looking to open up inside.
You can see Susie Bakovic helping there. She was right in the key as Burton had the ball up, which obviously helped help the defense to not throw that ball inside with a mismatch.
And Perth coming up with an air ball on that shot. So things kind of rolling Townsville's way at the moment. Kate Gaze is in the game for the first time. Mia Murray to make the inbounds. This is Michaela Cox. Perth still down court, putting pressure on.
These two here, offense and defense, playing the New Zealand national team together, so they know each other's game quite well. Oh, Susie just slips over there in the paint.
Whitcomb. Little hesitation play. Get unlucky not to finish. Gets it back. I bet she does this time.
Way to stay on it there by Whitcomb.
Murray, Bakovic. This is Gaze now. Back to Cox, on ball from Bakovic. Garbin gets the ball deflected away by Tomlinson. Good defense, good hands. Whitcomb looks, puts it on the floor. Cox was completely beaten there for foot speed.
That's tough there by Whitcomb. Obviously, you've got to guard that three-point shot, and Cox kind of lunged a little bit at it, and she just put it to the ground and got that layup. Townsville got to help out a little bit more on that split-line defense. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're at the 1 minute 44, away from half-time, very close to the half-time break, 39-33, as we said, both teams. Townsville's been a little bit in front for most of this quarter, but Perth is starting to dig in now and starting to work that little bit harder. Another timeout. The timeout was called by Chris Lucas. He'll be looking to have a chat to his girls about making sure they finish off this second quarter and go to the halftime break with the lead. And the other end of the floor, we'll have the Perth coach looking to just make sure that his girls have got everything sorted out as to how they want to go about finishing off the term.
I'm just having a quick look here at the stats, and it's good to see Townsville's five starters all got quite a few points to their name. Susie's one rebound away from a double-double. And also Michaela Cox has got 7 points, which is good to see.
And Mia Murray, she's got a couple there too.
Yeah, Mia Murray's got 10 points, which is good. 3 from 3 three-pointers.
And looking down the Perth lineup,
Whitcomb's got 10 points so far, 5 from 13 and 4 rebounds, and Levy's got five, but hopefully get a little bit more out of Anaja Laney in this last minute 44 here.
Yep, she's a tough customer. She'll hang in there. She'll be right there right to the final buzzer.
Absolutely.
Michaela Cox. Bakovic. There's Garbutt.
A back screen there for Susie, which saw her cutting to the basket, which is hard to guard. She's coming onto her left hand. An easy 2 points there for Suze.
Good execution as a team structure. Perth now looking to do the same. This is Tomlinson. Now Whitcomb. Pulls back. That is a tough shot to guard. That penetration step, jab step, and step back.
It really is, and she's mastered that. It's her signature move, and she makes that look really, really easy. But a great shot there by Whitcomb.
Garbutt. Murray goes baseline, gets fouled on the way in, has two shots to come. Just got head and shoulders past Laney on the way to the basket.
She did, and it looks like Laney and Tomlinson kind of run into each other there down near the block.
With some friendly fire.
Yep.
Neely is ticking that scoreboard over tonight. She had just 5 points in Perth last week, and she would have been disappointed with that. And Sherry Gallagher seeing plenty of court time tonight. She's just come back in for Mia Murray. I struggle with Murray and Neely. I courtside announced here a lot for the team over the last few years. She got married, and I'm struggling to get used to the idea.
So do I, actually. I played juniors with her back in South Australia, so she was always newly, and that's how I know her.
And she actually has family. Her mum comes from Townsville.
Yeah, and I saw them here tonight, Janelle and Arthur. Yeah. Wow, big block there by Susie. Yeah. That was great defense there by Susie, and we'll get Townsville fired up for this last.
Let's have another look at this one.
40 seconds.
She lined it up.
She did. She timed that really well.
Makes a defensive statement, but Perth still have another possession and an opportunity to put points
on
the board.
3-2. Shot clock. Great defense there by Townsville.
Cox looking to go to the rack. Nice pass to Garbutt. Garbutt's off to the free throw line. Again, good aggressive play.
That was a really good aggressive play there by Townsville, as you can see by the replay here. Cox dished that off to Garbutt. My fault, who attacked the basket and drew the foul.
Nice touch on the first one. 44-36 is that scoreline. At that 45. Novosel comes back in for Gallagher. That was a short trip. She was in and out.
It was. It was almost like she was just in for that defensive play, and then they've taken her back out. So smart there by Chris Lucas.
Levy with Gaze working hard to stay in contact. Clock's winding down to the halftime break. Laney gets the opportunity. It's long. Perth chase it down. Another chance with the dying seconds. Well, I don't know if that was away in time. It's halftime, guys. We're done. That went on for a little while after the buzzer there. The girls are really excited. Well, it's halftime here in Townsville. 45-36 is the scoreline. It's the Fire by 9 as the girls head to the change rooms for the major break. We'll be back shortly.
I choose to expect more from myself. It's a long way to the top, and I choose to go the distance. Whatever's ahead of me, I choose to be ready. And I choose to be there for bedtime. Choose your destiny.
James Cook University. Global ranking, top 4%.
Whether it's my game or my health cover, confidence is key. And knowing that Queensland Country Health Fund has added and improved benefits for the past 5 years gives me confidence that they're ahead of the game. And my health and fitness is covered. And that's why I switched. Hey Kelly, your shot.
Thanks, Laura.
And Queensland Country makes switching easy. In person, online, or on the phone. So stay healthy, be confident, and switch to Queensland Country Health Fund today.
There comes a time when we're called to say,
no thanks, I'm driving.
To do what must be done. To be decisive and compassionate. There's no medal, but the rewards are great. When you plan to drive dry, Queensland salutes you.
Authorised by the Queensland Government, Brisbane.
I want to be famous for my heart.
Down here, there's a lot to take care of. There's the meetings, the deadlines, the phone call you promised your mother, your gym bag full of wishful thinking, and your two-hour park in a one-hour space. But up here, everything's taken care of.
Shiraz or Riesling, sir?
Especially you.
Shiraz, please.
With food, checked baggage and entertainment now complimentary on Virgin Australia domestic flights.
All around the country, Australians have been speaking up with their thumbs. And we've heard you. Matt, nothing should come between you and a McMuffin. Simon, we know hash brown hunger can strike when you least expect. Danielle, no one should have to choose between hotcakes and a sleep-in. And now, you don't have to. Now you can enjoy your favourites for brekkie, brunch and brinner. Yes, Australia, it's breakfast time all the time at Macca's.
Bertie, you know how I've been running this amazing Wattle Valley shot clock at three-quarter time? No one here in Townsville actually made the grand final, but that's okay. Now, during the course of all of the games, not just here in Townsville, fans have been right around the country been able to have the chance to shoot it out, and at the conclusion, we found two leaders. Okay, we're going to take microphones. Okay, this is Lachlan, this is Joseph. Now, you both play basketball at home. Lockie, who do you play for?
Southwest Metro Pirates.
And how you going?
Pretty good.
That's good. Joseph, who do you play for?
Dandenong
Rangers. Dandenong Rangers. Now, before we get into the shooting, here are the rules. Both of the boys have 4 seconds on the shot run with the Wattle Valley shot clock all year. Now, if we have a tie at the end, what we're going to do is the boys are going to have a golden ball off. I'll explain that later. It's tough. Okay, now, are you confident?
Yes.
Are you confident, Joseph?
Yep.
Okay, all right. Well, it's going to be tough. Now, what we're playing for is $1,000 thanks to our Name Your Right sponsor, Wattle Valley. How good is that? Yes. Lucky, what would you do with a grand?
I would go towards my school fees and help my family out.
I was expecting him to say lollies. Were you all expecting lollies? Joseph, what about you?
I'm not really sure yet.
Lollies. We're going to the bar for lollies later. And also a WNBL ball, which has been fully signed 2016-17. WNBL team membership, all thanks to Wattle Valley as well. Now, Lockie, as the overall leader, because you came first and Joseph came second, do you want to shoot first or shoot second?
I'll shoot first.
Okay, you okay with that, Joseph?
Yep.
All right, then, here we go. Let's go to the free throw line, Lockie. Now, everyone, I need you to help me count because we all know I'm not an accountant. Are we right with that? Yeah? Okay. We got the 24 seconds. We got the music. Lockie, best of luck. Here we go. Now, let's go. Oh, one already. Two. Give him a round of applause. Three. Oh, seriously, someone from the Grok, sign him up. Is that four? Five. Oh, well done, Lockie. Five balls. You happy with that, Lockie?
Yeah.
Wait, yeah. Okay. Come on out, Joseph. Here we go. All right, you got to beat five. Can he beat five? Here we go. 24 seconds. Come on, everyone. Let's get behind him. Ready, Joseph? Go! You can do it. Come on, buddy. Here we go. It's a slippery hoop. One. Two. Three. Come on, buddy. Four. Quick, 2 seconds. Hurry up. Oh. Well done, Joseph. Lockie, congratulations. Champion effort. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Lockie is our champion winner. And onto the court from Wattle Valley is Sam Barutu. Sam, you must be so proud to support the WNBL and little champions like this.
We're extremely proud.
All right, congratulations. $1,000. Get a photo, you guys. Congratulations, Joseph. Give it up for Lachlan. He's $1,000 richer, and thank you to Wattle Valley.
And just another example of what Wattle Valley's doing for this National League, ladies and gentlemen, another $1,000 for the development of young basketballers. Folks, it's been a pretty special...
To pretend that I'm not home, because I think you're better to forget. And then I hear the rocks against my window, and I know you're a mistake I won't regret. But come what may, on a later day, yeah, I might get wet, but it's only right. I know what I'm here for and nothing more. We're all placing bets. It's only rain. I know what I'm here for, nothing more. We're all playing.
Down here, there's a lot to take care of. There's the meetings, the deadlines, the phone call you promised your mother, your gym bag full of wishful thinking, and your two-hour park in a one-hour space. But up here, everything's taken care of.
Shiraz or Riesling, sir?
Especially you.
Shiraz, please.
With food, checked baggage, and entertainment now complimentary on Virgin Australia domestic flights.
I choose to get a head start on the day. The early bird and all that. I choose to put in the hard yards. And I choose not to stop until the job's done. Even if it's weeks, months, a year. So while I'm here, we choose to make it feel like home. Choose your destiny.
In 2016, Townsville celebrates 150 years since being declared a municipality, triggering a year-long celebration of community-led festivals, events, concerts, exhibitions, and activities. Townsville, let's celebrate. Visit townsville150.com.au.
We've heard you. Matt, nothing should come between you and a McMuffin. Simon, we know hash brown hunger can strike when you least expect. Danielle, no one should have to choose between hotcakes and a sleep-in. And now, you don't have to. Now you can enjoy your favourites for brekkie, brunch and brinner. Yes, Australia, it's breakfast time all the time at Macca's.
There comes a time when we're called to say...
No thanks, I'm driving.
To do what must be done. To be decisive and compassionate. There's no medal, but the rewards are great. When you plan to drive dry, Queensland salutes you.
Authorised by the Queensland Government, Brisbane.
Change a child's life. Become a foster carer.
We're back in Townsville at RSL Stadium. Game two of the Wattle Valley Women's Grand Final Series for the WNBL. Abby Bishop with me in commentary, one of the stars of the Women's League and, of course, an Australian Open. We're going to talk a little bit about what you're up to a bit later on, Abby. But tell us what's been happening on the stat sheet there as we're almost about to get underway with the second half.
Yeah, look, a couple of things that stand out to me, obviously the shooting percentage. So Townsville is shooting the ball extremely well at 46.7%, whereas Perth is shooting it at 34.1%. They're probably the two biggest factors. And also for Perth there, there's two guards that are actually leading the rebounds, Leiby with six and Whitcomb with five. So I'm sure that'll be would have been addressed at halftime and we might see a change there.
Okay. Now, third quarter, you have the Fire hold a nine-point lead. How does the third quarter shape this thing? You know, you've got to be in the contest in that fourth quarter.
Yeah, third quarters are really, really important. And, you know, I expect both teams to come out firing here, but it's one of those quarters that you really push for and try and fight. So obviously Townsville got that advantage with the lead, but let's see what Perth can do here with the ball now.
Is if Perth can get it back on level terms, it really becomes anybody's game going into the fourth.
That's right, it really does. It's really important for Perth.
Whitcomb, another good baseline move, but nothing on. She kicks it back to Levy. She's inside this time. Shots off the mark and Bakovic reels in another one. That's that double-double that we talked about a moment ago for Susie.
That's right, her 10th rebound there.
Murray. George turns, looks inside to Bakovic, spins to the opposite hand. She'll be asking for the foul and not getting it. There's Susie, looks at the ref and says, hey, hang on, what the hell happened there?
Yeah.
Not enough, I don't think, Susie.
Here's the replay.
Let's have a look.
She kind of just lost her footing there. It was actually pretty good defense by Mijovic. Hands straight up.
Floor wiper's having to mop up some sweat. There's just a slight delay. Not any of the players getting hurt. Wherever you're joining us from across Australia watching this game, it's a sellout here in Townsville. I expect we'll have some fans watching it here in Townsville. Certainly in Perth, they'll be lined up. Backovic spins, has a miss. Good offensive rebound from Michaela Cox, but good work also from Perth to recover possession. Levy waving players around. Wickham from downtown, it's a miss, but a good offensive board for Perth gives Levy another opportunity and she doesn't make any mistake.
No, that's a big rebound there by Burton and a great kick out to Levy, who shot that ball confidently.
So Perth draw first blood at the start of this third term. Backovic looking inside at George, there's nothing there. Murray goes baseline, the jump shot is a little long, and this is Whitcomb now. Novosel with that assignment.
Great pass, but you know, obviously Townsville got their hands in there, but Whitcomb needs to shoot that one up herself.
Well, I think she gets to the free throw line too, or the chance to get to the line if you're aggressive at the rack.
That's right, it's better than throwing that one away.
Leaving. Inside to Laney. That's exactly what we're talking about there, Abby.
It is, that's right. You know, she draws that foul instead of risking that turnover by just kind of chucking it up there. So that's a good job by Laney there.
Tomlinson on the way back in. And Laney with two free throws to come. Missed the second free throw, but still 4 points to Perth to start this quarter. Murray pushes down court, but plenty of Perth players back. Kayla George recovers it. And again, good hands, good defense from Perth.
Yeah, great hands there by Whitcomb. She was here, there, everywhere. Offensive foul. Great defense by Cox there to get her feet in front. And here comes the replay now.
Well, she did do well, didn't she? Because Whitcomb is quick. She's quick on the crossover.
Yeah, absolutely. Whitcomb kind of dropped her shoulder a little bit, but Cox just had her feet in the right spot and great defense by her.
Fire yet to put something through the hoop this quarter. Maybe looking to get their scoring underway. Murray. Backovic comes to the high post. Just fumbles it a little. This is Novosel back to, oh, that pass was way wide of Susie Backovic. Leaving. Cross court. Whitcomb. Not this time, but Perth grab another rebound. Through Carly Mirovic. Beautiful move inside.
That was a great move there by Banaja, and that's going to get her rolling. And Chris Lucas has called a timeout here. He doesn't want the momentum to swing any more further than what it has. So I expect them to get a little earful here and hopefully come out ready to go after this timeout.
Well, Andy Stewart would be happy. It's not always been pretty, but they've been aggressive. And that's probably the most important thing. Take the game right up to the fire.
Yeah, that's right. And they've come out in this second half with that attacking mindset. And I think that's probably what he would have been after in that locker room at halftime. And they've done that. They've got it back to 3 points and chipping away, which is what you have to do. And you can see the girls really listening in there to him talking in this timeout. So they look very highly...
Motivated,
that's the word.
Doesn't it just escape you sometime, huh?
It does, yeah. It does.
But, you know, down the other end, Lucas would be, would be reassuring his players also. So, you know, just keep your head down. They've got off to a good start. And Perth's defense, I think, is where they've really made it happen by creating some opportunities too with some steals. So Townsville needs to get back in control of their offense. They've coughed it up a couple of times.
That's right, and I think probably just getting them to regroup and settle down a little bit, and I think we'll see a bit calmer and collected group here.
I see Susie having another chat with one of the referees. She likes to discuss things. Have you found her like that when you played with her? Is she always talking to the refs?
Oh, look, Susie loves a little chat to the refs, but, you know, she's the captain as well, so
true.
That's her job.
All right, let's see what the Fire can come up with out of that timeout. Perth trying to maintain that pressure. George. Murray has it. Shot clock's down to 5. Back inside. Good hands again from Perth. Another good defensive set. This is Whitcomb. Has been Igelani. Goes baseline. Murray was able to shut it down this time. On ball screen from Tomlinson.
Great
good
pass.
Bounce.
Sammy Whitcomb with that dish there to Tomlinson. That's a beautiful play. Good finish by Luella there too.
Look at that scoreline, folks. If you're a Perth fan, you're looking, you're smiling right now. It's 45-44. Perth have dragged back 8 of that 9-point margin at halftime. Crowd here in Townsville trying to motivate their players. Backovich can't get it done, but a good offensive rebound from Michaela Cox hunting down the loose ball. Novoselic goes baseline, looking for an option. Not much there, and again, good rotation from Perth. Again, running it down. Murray. Backovich and George are in there. George gets blocked. Another good defensive effort from Perth. It was Tomlinson coming up with the big play. Levy at the other end, and Perth are in front.
And here they come. You know, Perth are doing a great job down that defensive end, and Townsville just need to take a big, deep breath, and they'll be right here.
Just got to break the ice, haven't they? And get that first basket away and start to get settled back into the game. But good work from Perth. Their defense has been excellent. Look at this again. Another block shot from Tomlinson and scrambling and chasing from Perth, but it comes back to Townsville. Michaela Cox has been quiet on the scoreboard so far. Another one from Perth. Good defensive set. Murray trying to force a jump ball. Comes up with a foul instead.
And, you know, she puts her hand up and says, you know, that's my foul. But it's getting a little bit, not rough. You know, we love a rough game, but it's kind of getting a little bit, yeah,
scrappy.
Rough. Yeah, scrappy, that's the word, exactly. So I think that foul there will settle it down a little bit.
All right, Levy brings it back for Perth. This is Whitcomb. Laney. Shot misses, but Laney is off to the free throw line. So time for some changes, perhaps, for certainly for Chris Lucas. Darcy Garbin is coming back in. Going to rest Kayla George. I think there's a sub has been called on the shooter from Perth, so her replacement is just waiting for Benaja Laney to take these shots. I think Townsville got as much as 5 points behind during the third quarter in Perth last week, but were able to bounce back. So Perth also will be very wary of what... Oh, great play again. And just really that was a little sloppy from Townsville.
It was, and Benaja Laney was right there ready to pick that one off. You could see it.
You know, Perth have all the momentum at the moment. They're really hunting down the ball carrier. Cox now. Inside to Batkovic, she's missed the pass, and again it's Perth. Give it to Perth. Their defense is just outstanding at the moment.
Mijovic with the big three.
That's a huge momentum swinger.
Yeah, that's big. Townsville just need to take a deep breath here and just settle down and get through a play.
-0 we have so far in this quarter. Perth. All Perth at the moment, both ends of the floor. Mirovic sets the on ball for Whitcomb. Garbin has that assignment. She goes baseline. A good reverse layup, but just a little off the mark as Batkovic gets it. Goes to Novosel. She has Cox on her right. As the Fire look to slow it, settle it.
You can hear Susie there calling the play, telling the girls to get through it, which is what they need.
Darcy Garbin goes inside. Again, the ball is wide, and Perth immediately on the run. Whitcomb baseline, just too quick for Novosel.
Here we see another timeout.
Chris Lucas has some problems.
Yeah, he's seen enough here. He's going to rally his troops together and see if he can get them going.
We have a break for a second.
All around the country, Australians have been speaking up with their thumbs, and we've heard you. Now you can enjoy your favourites for brekkie, brunch and brinner. Macca's all-day breakfast is finally here.
All right, Perth's defence has been just sensational here to open the third quarter in Townsville. They trailed by 9 at the major break. They're now leading by 7. It is all Perth. Chris Lucas has some problems. I don't know what he's going to do to rectify the situation, but he's had 2 timeouts in this quarter already. One certainly earlier just to break the momentum, but now it's becoming more than just momentum. The Towns will have possession coming out of that timeout, so a chance to get something through the hoop. But again, they need to be aggressive too, don't they, Abby? They've kind of, I know the defense has stepped up, but they've kind of backed off a little.
Yeah, they have a little bit, and I think they've focused a little bit too much on going inside. That's where they've got a couple of turnovers, but let's see what they run here. You can see Perth in a zone, a 2-3 zone, mixing things up. Danny Whitcomb directing her troops there.
Kayla Cox in the corner. They desperately need to battle. It is a 3.
Big shot there by Cox.
Crowd suddenly came alive. They've hadn't had much to cheer about in the first 7 minutes of this quarter. 3 minutes away from three-quarter time. The margin now is 6 points. Mirovic. This time, it's the fire forcing the turnover.
Yeah, and that was good, D, and good pressure there by Townsville. They need to continue that, and, good things happen.
Perth remaining up, putting pressure on the ball carrier, using up some of that shot clock. Cox comes off the screen from Darcy Garvin. She gets baseline, powers it up. No foul on the play. Good work again from Perth. Everyone's chasing the loose ball, and it's the Lynx who have it. Pull up from Whitcomb. That could have been a dagger if that one had gone down, but Townsville survive. Here's a chance now in the corner. 3 points this time, and it's Tony Edmondson.
And they had a second chance there, and Townsville just got to box out a little bit better and not let them get that second shot off.
Bakovic from the 3-point line.
Yeah, Suze. Big shot there by Suze.
Well, she certainly can shoot the 3.
That's right. And, you know, she's one of those players that's going to step up when you need her. And that was a big shot.
So for Townsville, it's about stringing 3 or 4 stops together if they can. Levy on ball from Tomlinson. Levy gets a look at it. Shot was well short. This is Murray now driving it down court. She has Garvin. Garvin goes up, gets fouled, and is on the way to the free throw line. Just good fast break basketball there, Abby. Getting the runners.
Yeah, that was Garvin again. You know, she had one earlier in that first half where she really attacked the basket and ran the floor really well. And it's great to see her continuing to do that throughout the game.
Okay, some pressure now at the free throw line for Darcy. You know, it's grand final. Looking to win the championship here tonight rather than go back to Perth. Perth dearly looking to take it to game 3. The first time in the history of the WNBL too, Abby, that we've had a 3-game series.
Yeah, and I love it. I think it's great for the league. I think it's just great all around the 3-game series. So great to see it happening for the first time this season.
Good work from Novosel. She's away. The chase is on. So the 2 points go down. And that is 57-54. We're back to a 3-point game. And what is now becoming a true arm wrestle. Laney. Sherry Gallagher has the foul on that one. We'll wait to see if it's shot. No, it's not. It's just an end line ball. Let's just watch this one. Lacey was still dribbling the basket. Lacey, I'll get it right in a moment, was still dribbling the basketball at the time. So it is an end line ball. Just taking a moment to mop up some sweat as the coaches there confer. Claudia Brassard, a former Fire player, former Canadian international, played for Canada at the Olympics some years back. Was a great player for the Fire in the club's early days. Good inbounds play, good execution.
That was great execution there, a great back screen and a good finish there by Lainey.
Novosel, good work from Whitcomb defensively. Novosel gets it inside, that is a big, big bucket. Again, that's where I think they needed to go, was aggressive. Let's have a look at the replay. That's a tough shot, splitting the defense.
Who was that foul on? Tomlinson.
Yeah, didn't see.
Tomlinson, yeah. Good finish there by Novosel to stay focused and make that shot under pressure.
Chance now for a three-point play with the bonus free throw. Every point is starting to become very precious here to both teams. Free throw is on the mark. 59-57, Perth by two. Lainey working, jump shot, doesn't get it. Taylor George grabs the rebound, looks for an outlet pass. Kate Gaze is on the floor now for Townsville. Running the backcourt. A lot of pressure there from Perth. Sherry Gallagher looking for an inside option. Garbin has George. She looks to be aggressive. Gets stripped. Good hands from Whitcomb. Slowing things down. Clock winding down as we head towards the three-quarter time break. Perth will take the last shot. Whitcomb. Quick crossover. Kicks it out.
Great pass.
Shot at the corner.
Good shot by Burton in the short corner there, but Whitcomb did a great job to get that defense. And we've got the... Ooh.
Wasn't too far away. Well, that is three-quarter time here in Townsville, folks. It is Perth 61, Townsville 57.
There comes a time when we're called to say...
No thanks. I'm driving.
Good man.
To do what must be done. To be decisive and compassionate. There's no medal, but the rewards are great. When you plan to drive dry, Queensland salutes you.
Authorised by the Queensland Government, Brisbane.
Whether it's my game or my health cover, confidence is key. And knowing that Queensland Country Health Fund has added and improved benefits for the past 5 years gives me confidence that they're ahead of the game. And my health and fitness is covered. And that's why I switched. Hey, Kelly, your shot.
Thanks, Laura.
And Queensland Country makes switching easy. In person, online, or on the phone. So stay healthy, be confident, and switch to Queensland Country Health Fund today.
Well, we're back and it's almost championship quarter. It was a great third term for Perth. 25 points to 12 they outscored the Townsville Fire. And it really is now a sensational contest. 61-57 is the scoreline. It is Perth by four. The local crowd is trying to get the girls up and running here with the chants being led by our cheerleaders here in Townsville. And this is going to be one heck of a final quarter. What do you see in the stats there, Abby?
Yeah, look, obviously the fact that Perth outscored Townsville there by quite a bit in that third quarter. But also the scoring has kind of stepped up for both teams. We've got four people in double figures for Perth and we've also got four people in double figures for Townsville. So I think, like you said, most big games are all about defence. So I think it's all going to come down to the defence in this last quarter.
Well, Townsville showed us what they could do defensively throughout most of the first half, and then Perth came back and returned the favour. So it's going to be the pressure on now. The players, the coaches, even the officials are under a lot of pressure out there now. This is the Fire, as you can see, coming back out onto the court. They will have possession, courtesy of the possession arrow, to start this final term. They would dearly love to get away with a basket straight away. And Perth stepping up, applying some double-team pressure to the inbounds pass. Makovic grabs it and hands back to Cox. This is Kayla George now. Novosel. Back screen set for Susie, but that's nothing coming from that. She looks to make something happen. Perth had a deflection in there, but just wasn't able to quite get it. And that is a big, big basket from Novosel.
It is a big basket from Novosel, and it was great of the Townsville's bigs to recognise the collapse inside and kick it back out.
Some pretty physical contact there as Laney was trying to wake her way through that cut. This is Levy. Gets inside. She kicks it out. Burton, Whitcomb. Defense slipped. Ball doesn't go down. Nobody wanted the rebound all of a sudden.
Oh, there's Whitcomb again.
Yeah, she's a hunter, isn't she? Loves the loose ball. Laney throws the shot fake. Slips slightly on the way in and turns the ball over in the end. Townsville. Looking to try to build the momentum starting this fourth quarter, I should say. Kayla George goes baseline. Offensive foul called to the extended forearm.
Yeah, good D there by Lou. Maybe a bit unlucky, but for Kayla, she made a nice move. The arm did go out a little bit.
Probably she just bounces on it, but she probably extended it just enough to catch the referee's attention. So Kayla picks up the foul. There's that scoreline for you, a one-point game. We're in the final term of Game 2. Townsville can win it from here. Perth want to take it home for Game 3 on Sunday. Baseline, Laney pulled up by George. Big shot from a long way out, and it's well wide of the basket. That was Luella Tomlinson launched that one. Michaela Cox exploring, nothing on. Good work in recovering defense from Perth. Bakovic down low, turns and shoots, rocks around. I think it's come off Perth. No. Wow, looked like Perth from here, but Perth won't mind. They'll take the possession.
Here's the replay.
Quite a two hands in there. Yeah. Bit hard to tell from that angle. We'll give the refs the benefit of the doubt. Wouldn't if I was playing or coaching. Crowd certainly didn't think so, no. Good work again defensively now. As we said, defense winning games, Abby.
That's
Townsville
right.
Townsville stepping up.
Yep, they are indeed. And it's good to see. It's obviously helping them get the ball back.
Wow, what a play from Mia Murray. Split the defense, got the reverse way up to fit.
And I don't know if you could see, but I just love the Townsville's bench. You know, they're up and jumping around and really, really getting involved.
Whitcomb, Bakovic did enough to slow her down this time. Ball goes to Laney. This time it's Murray working hard defensively. Laney gets it in there. No contact called on that play. And Townsville come up. Yep, for a moment there I thought they were going to cough it up. This game is getting very, very physical out here right now. The referees are letting the girls play. Novosel looked inside, kind of changed her mind three times there. Kayla George hasn't put too many away tonight, but she's come up with one now at the right time and is the fire now by three. 64-61, and the crowd here in Townsville are really getting into this. Whitcomb looking to change things. Great hustle from Laney, great hustle.
Yeah, putting bodies on the line, you know, obviously this game is a big one. Grand final game too, but yeah, throwing their bodies everywhere.
Tony Edmondson comes in for Laney, for Perth, and so returning to is Natalie Burton for Tomlinson. Perth with the baseline inbounds. Shot clock, or not shot clock, but a entry violation. Time elapsed, and the Fire are just stoked with that play. And as you said, the bench is up. There you go.
I'm loving the bench. They were pretty much all on the court there for a second.
Get some extra court time on your stats, huh? All right, it's still 64-61, a three-point game. No call. Now it is. Wow, that took a long time for the referee. He kind of let that go. But once Novosel was clearly disadvantaged, he blew the call. Just the one team foul each so far, so that's you've got to keep an eye on those that aspect of the game as well. So once either team reaches five, it can become a free throw contest, so we'll watch that count for you. Perth applying plenty of pressure on the entry pass again. Cox, Murray has it. Screen there for Bakovic to go to the low post, but nothing happening. This time it's Kayla George. She's looking to get something done and does this time. Again, a good aggressive play. Didn't put the elbow out this time, Abby.
No, she didn't. She went up strong and Mio just brought her hands down a little bit there and drew the foul.
A little discussion there between Andy Stewart and the referees. You've always got to get, there's an opportunity during free throws for the coaches to have a chat. I don't know how much they really influence the outcome, but if nothing else, you feel better if you've made your point.
Well, that's right.
Kayla, second shot. Both of them down. 65-66-61, a five-point game. Again, it'll be about defensive stops now. Which team can get it done and give themselves the opportunity to build? Mirovic. Traveling call. Crowd is really coming alive here in Townsville now, and that's going to mean an awful lot to the energy levels for the Fire. Timeout has been called by Stewart. Takes his team to the bench. It was all Perth during that third quarter. Townsville have done a really good job of turning the tide.
Yeah, they have. You know, Townsville have come out really strong here and up their ante with their defense and obviously just making some attacking plays at the basket, which is really helping them and drawing some fouls.
Do you think the referees are letting this game get along a bit too? There's been some fairly physical contact out there. I know referees don't like to overcall finals.
Yeah, look, I think it's getting more physical as the game's going on and they are letting it. But, you know, I think that's fine as long as it's both ways kept, kept the same. I think it's great to see a physical game, but, yeah, it's just got to be kept both ways.
That's always the tough thing for referees too, isn't it? Because when you do let some things go, when you make that call, you're probably going to suffer some criticism. But anyway, they're doing a reasonably good job tonight, these guys. I don't see them influencing the outcome of the game. It's both teams are getting an opportunity here, and you're not seeing coaches or players react much, which will always give an indication of how they see things are going. Folks, we've got 6 minutes 26 remaining in this grand final, or the second game of the grand final series. And they're in the final quarter, if you've just joined us. It is Townsville leading this one, 66-61 right now. Just a five-point margin. Still very much anybody's game. Towns will have another possession now to look to try and extend that. Perth have been very aggressive defensively. They're right down court, looking to apply pressure to the inbounds. Levy up against Michaela Cox. Brings the ball back to Townsville. Bakovic is there. Set an on ball. Not much contact on that, so not much effect. Novosel goes inside. Great play from Novosel. She's come alive in this quarter as well.
She has. She's been tough tonight. Her defensive pressure and making a few big buckets when it's been needed.
Wickham inside to Tomlinson. Looks to go one-on-one with Bakovic. Turns. Bakovic is all over her. Susie just kept good position all the way through that set, Abby.
Yeah, she did. Suze had tough defense. I think Lou should have probably kept going on that right hand instead of stepping through. Suze didn't actually bite at that one.
Murray now. Double team on the ball, but Murray not in any hurry. Wants to make sure that they don't fire something up too quickly and try to keep building on what they've started during this fourth quarter. Cox now inside, kicks it out. Novosel goes to three, and it's down. Huge shot, and the crowd is just going berserk. 71-61, a 10-point margin. This is what Townsville did to Perth in Perth last weekend when they got away from them in that fourth quarter. Can Perth respond? Struggling now. Jump ball call, the possession arrow faces Perth. So Perth will get the ball back, but at the same time for the Fire, it's a defensive statement.
Absolutely, they were all over that one.
5 minutes to go, still plenty of time, but a 10-point margin in a grand final is it's the position you want to be in that final turn. Good inbounds play. But Bakovic is there to force the pass back out. This is Levy. She takes it inside. Michaela Cox responds well. Laney shots away. Is it counted? No, it's waved away by the officials. The shot clock violation.
There goes that defense again.
Timeout has been called. And this is all of this. Wow, this game has changed so much, hasn't it? Been through the third quarter, now the fourth. This did, you know, Perth really put the pedal down in the third. Do you think they've spent what energy they've got, or have they got something more to come back with?
Yeah, look, I think they'll give it one more little crack here, but they could have well and truly spent that energy, and Townsville kind of almost not saved it up, but they're saving their last run until the most important part. But yeah, by all means, it's definitely not all over yet, but Townsville are in a great position.
So I guess what you could say is that Townsville held their nerve somewhat late in that third term. You know, Perth could have got away from them, but they kind of dug in and just kept fighting through to the break and then gone to work from there.
Well, that's right, and you've got to look at Townsville as well. They're quite experienced. They've been here before. You know, whereas Perth, they've got a couple of younger kind of girls and maybe experienced, but maybe not. I'm not sure if they've been in too many WNBL grand finals. So I think that always helps Townsville as well, the experience.
Well, losing them helps you to learn how to win them, and Townsville were in two consecutive finals against Bendigo and got beaten.
Absolutely.
Before they managed to pick up the club's first championship last year.
Yeah.
Our players making their way back out on court. Coaches have had their opportunity to talk to the teams. More of the same, I think, would be Chris Lucas's instructions out there. Control the ball, work hard on the defensive end. Don't cough it up, keep the turnovers down, and you've probably got this thing done. Perth, on the other hand, they've come up court. They're looking to really apply some pressure, try to get the fire to turn the ball over and maybe get some cheap possessions to start to run down that 10-point lead. This could be a killer. And it is a triple from Michaela Cox.
Huge shot there by Cox, and you can see Townsville are really just using that momentum. Here's Levy.
Just didn't bounce for her.
Burton just went to try and save that and accidentally whacked Kayla in the face there, but she was just trying to save the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, I think the two players kind of, you know, Burton gave her a quick apology.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, no issue. Right now, I don't think Kayla would be feeling too much with that 13-point lead. Good steal for Perth. Kayla says, well, you ain't going to get it on a layup. So the Fire have done a good job on Lacey tonight. You know, I watched her here in that semi-final series, and she was tough and put some good numbers up that night. But they've really made her work very hard tonight for what she's got.
Yeah, she has had to work really hard for what she's got, and a little bit different from last week's game as well over in Perth. But I guess that's a credit to Townsville. They've obviously came out and adjusted to a few things that...
Well, switching the on-ball screens and stuff like that earlier on, which is different to what they've normally done.
Yeah, absolutely. And even just the pressure on defense, I think, is...
Well, let's not ride Perth off just yet. There's 4.5 minutes to go in this game, and they're going to give this their best shot.
Perth definitely need a stop right here.
Novosel comes back to George. He goes inside to Bakovic. Oliver's a clean swipe. 4 seconds left on the shot clock here, so Townsville not with too much time to get themselves a shot. But off it's not a bad thing coming off an end line inbounds play to get that shot away with 4 seconds remaining. You get to run something structured.
Yeah, that's right. Let's see what they've got here.
Murray in behind. She's going to have to get this thing up pretty quickly. Shot clock ran out. So good work there from Perth on that defensive set. Townsville now extending their defense up the floor. Not looking to deny the inbounds, but as I said, a bit of pressure up the floor uses up shot clock time as well. Levy. Couple of crossovers. Back to Laney. Newley in there to help. Kayla George comes up with the steal. Michaela Cox. patience from Townsville. Nothing being done in a hurry. Novosel gets it. And, yep, it did come off the foot of the Townsville player who was on the floor. The official's getting it right. 3 minutes 42 to go in game two of this grand final series. It is Townsville by 11. Laney looking for help. This is Levy. Takes it inside, kicks it back out. Another penetration play. Tomlinson was down inside, but perhaps wasn't expecting the pass. Bankovic brings it back. She wants to go coast to coast as Susie. Not much scoring going on at the moment, Abby.
No, there's not here. It's a bit up and back, but Townsville have got that nice little lead, so it's... You know, oh, goodness.
Kayla with the don't argue.
Yeah, a little shove there. That was a foul, so...
I didn't do it. You know she did, Abby, don't you?
Oh, Kayla.
She hit me in the face. I've got to do something back.
Yeah, they always catch the retaliation one. Yeah.
So she wasn't happy about being whacked in the face. Well, you said she was okay with it. I said she was okay with it. She wasn't. Laney has it. Gets it on ball. Big three-point basket there from Carly Mirovich. 2 minutes 45 remaining. Scoreline back to 8. They said Perth are not out of this game yet. Novosel takes it in. Good defense from Perth. Whitcomb, Perth get a score here. They're going to feel like they've got a sniff of the scent.
Great pick up.
Levy, Whitcomb in the corner, fires the three. It's a little short.
It's a big box out there by Mia Murray.
Very important rebound.
Absolutely.
Cox.
And there she goes from that rebound to a beautiful backdoor play. Great finish there by Mia.
Got a substitution coming in for Perth. So I thought there was a timeout coming because just about every player on the fire bench, plus the coaches, plus the manager and even the bloke who fills the water bottles was up.
Yeah, 2 minutes and 8 seconds left.
The guy who fills the water bottles is a good mate of mine.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure he's being excited. He is actually the father-in-law of last year's captain.
Oh, okay.
Wickham goes inside. Gets it back in the corner. Fires. Off the mark. Everybody's after the loose ball. Now it's going to go jump ball. This time the arrow favours the fire. 1 minute 51 to go and a 10-point margin. Can't see Perth coming back from here, but the Fire have got to make sure they wind this, close this thing out. The fans are starting to celebrate around us here, but I wouldn't celebrate too soon. As you know, Abby, a couple of three-point shots can change the complexion of things very quickly. There she is. There's Rachel. Yes. She decided it was time to retire, and she didn't waste too much time working on growing a family.
That's right. Bunny and the other man. It's great to see her still involved with the program.
Cox slows it down, using up the time. George, now Batkovic. Cross to Murray, inside to George. Good shot option. Gets a friendly bounce. Things are really rolling the way of the Fire right now. Laney, aggressive, gets fouled.
Everyone here. We
have to all be on. Natalie Burton coming back in for Mirovich. Makes the first. 11 points the margin again. Susie chasing down the rebounds. Kayla George, good pass downtown. She's got to push in the back. And she goes for the free throws now as well.
That was a good kick ahead there. Kayla was obviously, here we see on the replay, Mia threw that ball up and Burton was still on her way back. So a great catch by Kayla and way to get it up. So she's got free throws to come.
1 minute 22 remaining in game two of the three-game series. It certainly looks now like Townsville will go back-to-back with championships after taking out their first ever title last year. I must say, after I watched Perth beat them here in Townsville, I had some doubts about whether they would get this done.
Yeah, I wasn't too sure either. It was kind of a hard one to pick, but, you know, Townsville are always hard to beat here on their home court. But, yeah, like you said, having Perth been over here and beating them here, it was always going to be the unknown.
So it's this is coach time, and how do you pull a rabbit out of the hat now? It's, you know, it's 13 points. All you do is you give your girls something, I guess, to work with. They're going to have to stay up the floor. They're probably going to have to look to shoot quickly. You know, you got to get the shots up quicker when you've got so little time.
Exactly right. You've got to stop Townsville from scoring. You've got to get defensive stops, and you've also got to put points on the board pretty quickly with a minute 22 to go, and you're down by 13. So it's going to be, yeah, it's going to be tough here for Perth, but we'll see how they come out of this time out.
Well, the Fire do have four team fouls in this this last term, but I don't know if that's going to make too much difference, even if they do put Perth on the line. I think they're going to use up a lot of the clock. I can't see Townsville rushing anything. They'll wind it down and wind it down, and then Perth will be forced to foul to not let that time elapse.
Yeah, that's right. And then it's two shots. And
yeah, free throw practice.
Yeah, that's exactly.
And that's the time of the game where you make sure you put the ball in the hands of your best free throw shooters, whoever they are.
Absolutely, and I'm sure they've practiced for these kind of moments during the week even.
It's Levy. Now Wickham back to Levy. As I said, here comes the quick shots. You know, that thing goes down, that's great for Perth. It didn't. Tomlinson. Mainly a lot of time being used up here. She gets it back. Levy pulls the trigger. Off the mark. Perth get it again. Whitcomb now. Just not going to happen for them. But again, they're rushing. Everything's about the clock.
That's right. Perth have to foul here because they're going to play it out.
This is where you hang on to the ball, don't you? Get yourself some free throws as a player.
Yeah, no.
You don't?
Nah.
Come and hit me. Susie from a long, long way out. The shot clock wound out, but it really had no bearing on the situation. 32.1 seconds remaining.
We've got everyone hugging there over on the Townsville bench. We've got the crowd standing up. We've got the camera crew right in there.
Yes, the celebrations have already started. And that is a great shot down in the corner for Mirovic. We practically can't see the players anymore here from where we are, Abby. I know there's a game happening out there. It's on the monitor for us, though. Bakovic just winding it down. Murray doing the same. 12 seconds remaining. I think Perth will just let this thing wrap up now. And that is, there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Game two in Townsville after a wonderful win over in Perth. Gave the Fire the opportunity to come back to Townsville and win this thing. Look at the celebrations here on the floor and around the building. Abby and I can see the crowd going nuts. A 10-point win to Townsville, 80 points to 70.
Yeah, it was a great game. Credit to Townsville. Also credit to Perth. A great fourth series. And, you know, Townsville just came out today and really controlled the momentum. So congratulations to the Townsville Fire.
Well, you know, great final series. Takes two teams to make it happen. Perth have had an outstanding season. And we congratulate them, as you said. There's the girls, lots of hugs. There's a couple of thousand people fit into this centre here at RSL Stadium. Almost all of them are wearing their red shirts. The girls there just exchanging handshakes and congratulations and commiserations. I mean, you always say well done to the guy you just beat, but geez, you're really pleased to beat them.
That is true.
In just a moment, we'll probably have the courtside, one of our courtside announcers will be doing some interviews, and we've got one, I think, coming up with Susie Bakovic. Thank you.
It was a big night for the girls. And you won again, back-to-back premierships. You were the first national team to bring home a championship to Townsville. You've done it back-to-back. I have here the game ball of the night. I'm giving it to our awesome captain, Susie B.
I just want to thank each and every one of you. You guys come out every week. And we can't do it without you, and to have this stadium filled and you backed us the whole game, we got nothing but you guys are MVPs for us tonight. Thank you.
Let's hear it for our girls. Come on.
Thank you very much. It was a typical grand final, wasn't it? And I was a bit concerned 5 minutes into the third, but as our team showed all year, terrific character and just kept on fighting at the defensive end, and just rewards for the team.
Well, that's exactly what Abby and I were talking about during the course of the game, just how important your defence would be, and you win it on that end of the floor in these big games, don't you?
Oh, you do. And look, offensively, you know, we didn't have any flow, and that's credit to Perth. I thought they really took us out of some of our stuff, but I went with a play that I'm really comfortable with down the stretch, and that really gave us some momentum, and momentum at the defensive end too. So, you know, terrific job by the team, and you know, big call to call that second time out, but I think I had to stop the rod in the third quarter. But I'm stoked back to back. I think it's fantastic for the city.
So tell us what you were thinking during that third term, because you had two good quarters coming up to half time. All of a sudden the tide started to turn. I felt like you kind of just dug in and kept your composure. Is that what it was about?
Yeah, look, I was a bit concerned, obviously, but, you know, I talk about the players maintaining composure, but I probably lost it there for a little bit. But, I think the composure at the right time was fantastic.
So, as you said, back-to-back championships now. You're building a dynasty here in Townsville.
Yeah, look, it's been five wonderful years and, made the finals in the first year and built a culture and... you know, every year we had five changes this year, and to build the team and lost an import at Christmas time. So, you know, terrific result. I don't know what to say. I'm stoked for the team.
Well, one last thing before we let you go back to the girls. Being in Townsville, Townsville just love their sporting teams. Your crowd behind you has been fantastic. What's it like to play here in this city with these people?
Yeah, look, it's amazing because. Even last week, you know, some of the social media on Perth is completely different here. Even when we play poorly or lose, they don't go after you, they support you. I'm sure we could have got another 1,500, 2,000 people in here if we could have today. And, you know, I think it's just a great reward for a great association.
Well, Chris, congratulations once again. Back-to-back championships with the Fire. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Would you please welcome to a very proud stadium Mr. Paul Maley, the General Manager of WNBL and Competitions, and Mr. Chris O'Sullivan, the CEO of Monday Nissan, the parent company of Wattle Valley. And we'll just ask Chris to come and say a few words if he would, please.
Thank you. Evening, everyone. What a great crowd. Fantastic, guys. And two great teams worthy of a grand final. Fantastic game put on by two fantastic teams. Perth, commiserations. Obviously had a fantastic year leading the league at the end of the regular season. And from where you were last year, what a great turnaround. Fantastic effort. Townsville, back to back. Great job. Wattle Valley, very proud to be part of the WNBL. Three seasons now. Looking forward to what might happen in the future, and we'll talk about that some more, Paul. Great job by Basketball Australia and the WNBL, putting on a fantastic season. It's a great product. Hopefully you like Wattle Valley products, and for Townsville, you're out buying our dips and cheeses as well when you're celebrating. So fantastic, everyone, and enjoy the rest of the evening.
Unfortunately, of course, there has to be a team that comes second, but you have to congratulate Perth on the quality of their season. We asked their captain, Tessa Levy, to come and say a few words if she would.
First of all, to our girls, bad luck, incredible season we've had this year, and we're just looking forward to the next season coming out. Fortunately, it didn't turn out how we would have liked it to, but we'll come out next year fighting hard again. To the league, to the... To the WNBL, thank you again for putting on a wonderful league. To all the sponsors in the WNBL, we thank you very much. Congratulations to the Townsville Fire, worthy winners. Well done. Thank you for Townsville for having us, and of course to our association at the Perth Lynx and the Perth Wildcats. Thank you very much for the support we've had this season. It's been absolutely brilliant. Thank you.
We're now about to announce the winner of the Rachel Sporn WNBL Grand Final MVP. We'll ask Paul Maley to come and award it if he would.
Okay, obviously there were many good players over the last two games. The medal is for the player of the series, and we just think that the player who had a fantastic game one and game two and had such an influence on the result was Michaela Cox.
Thank you.
First of all, I just want to say thanks to the Townsville City, all the fans. You're the best fans in Australia. We couldn't do it without you. That was the loudest stadium I've ever played in. It was awesome atmosphere. Loved it. Most importantly, thank my teammates. They're awesome. I love all of them. Back-to-back champions. And it's great to get this award, but it means nothing without the championship. And my teammates, we all deserve this. Let's go fire up Townsville.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like you to welcome our Aussie Hoops participants who will be awarding the championship medals to each of our team members as we call them forward. Please join with me as we welcome them up. Number six, Ainsley Walsh. Wattle Valley MVP, All-Star 5, starting 5, playing her 100th game tonight. Captain of the JCU Townsville Fire, number 8, Susie Batkovic. Number 9, ladies and gentlemen, Sherry Gallagher. Number 10, Mia Murray. Number 11, Kate Gaze. Number 12, Jackie Zelenka. Number 14, Darcy Garbin. Number 20, Shivana Palvas. Number 22, oh, beg your pardon, number 21, Natalie Novosel. How can I do that to you? Number 22, Kayla George. And number 32, the Rachel Sporn WNBL Grand Final MVP winner, Michaela Cox. Our coach, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Lucas, back to back. His assistants, Claudia Brissard, Mark Roble, Rachel McCulley, so folks, do you want to hear Susie talk? Ladies and gentlemen, captain of the JCU Townsville Fire, your captain, Susie Batkovic.
Thanks, guys. I've just got a few people I want to thank. Thanks to Andy, Teth and the Lynx for such a great series. Thanks for that. Wattle Valley and the WNBL sponsors, James Cook as our naming rights partner, South 32 as a major partner and my personal sponsor, Quest Service Apartments and major partner and today's game day sponsor, Mike Carney Toyota, Queensland Country Health Fund, Jewelry by Design and McDonald's for their ongoing support. I'm only halfway, guys, I'm only halfway. Townsville City Council for everything that they do for us, providing us with this state-of-art venue. Townsville RSL, where we'll be getting the party started tonight with all of our other sponsors, who we could not have done this without your support. Now, to our 1,500 season ticket holders and our loyal fans, this one's for you. To our volunteers, the board and the front office, you give us the best possible chance to win this, so thank you. To the coaching staff and my amazing playing group, well done, we did it. Back-to-back champions. And finally, to my family and friends and all our players, family and friends, thanks for your support. Make sure you come out for a drink.
Ladies and gentlemen, we asked Chris Lucas if he'd say a couple of words. Ladies and gentlemen, the man with the plan, your coach, Chris Lucas.
Look, first of all, I'd like to congratulate Andy and your team. What a wonderful performance this year. We knew it was going to be tough today, and I think you should be really proud of your team. They're tough. It's a really tough situation that you're in today, but I can assure you, being there and done that, and I'm sure your players will learn from it. So congratulations to you, your team and yourself. Had a great year. I'd like to thank, and I don't want to miss anybody. I've just got an amazing support group. Claudia, I yell at her all the time. It's like we're like a married couple. So it's, she's a terrific assistant. Mark's done a terrific job as well. All my support staff, and including Big John, Donna, the doctors. I went around for my fourth coffee yesterday, and I rocked back at the stadium, and it's 20 past two, and Johnny's walking in. I said, "Well, mate, what are you doing here, mate? We don't train for 2 hours." He said, "I'm nervous." So I thought, his commitment through the year has been great. To Max, our physio, Kevin, our doctor. And a special thanks to Joe Lucan, who helps me personally during the year and individual athletes during the year. Fantastic support for us. Thank you, Joe. I'd like to thank the board. It's an amazing club to work for. There's no hassles. Anything you ask for, they're in the background. They look after us. I think we should be really pleased with this board and the professional way that they operate. I'd like to thank the supporters. I think you guys are absolutely amazing. I think there's no question you helped us get across the line today, and we really appreciate that. Thank you. To this team this year, we actually we had 5 changes from last year's team. Susie, nominated captain this year, and believe me, we butt heads at times, but it's a love-hate relationship. But Susie, you've done an amazing job, and what a wonderful team. Congratulations. So, thank you, and let's enjoy tonight and make a mess of Townsville.
There's only one thing remains. We're going to ask Chris O'Sullivan, CEO of Mondo Nissan, parent company of Wattle Valley, if he would hand over the trophy to the winning coach and the winning captain of your team, the JCU Townsville Fire. So ladies and gentlemen, there are two opportunities you have to meet and greet your team. One is at the RSL tonight at the Charters Towers Road in the sports bar. The other is 11 o'clock Sunday morning in the Cottage Market. Come along, there'll be autographs, I dare say. People will be very happy, but make sure you come and meet and greet your team either tonight at the RSL straight after this or at the Cottage Market on Sunday morning at 11 a.m. We look forward to seeing you there, folks. See you in both. Michaela, have you got scissors? You're going to cut the net? Yeah, where's the scissors? Where's your scissors? Where's McCully? Have we got scissors? They're up there. Okay, who's up first? Michaela's up there first. They're on top of the ladder. Now, don't hurt yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, the cutting of the net. Kayla George. Tell us if you need a hand, won't you, Kayla? Are they left-handed scissors? Kate's up next. Go, Kate.
Jackie. Up next, Ainsley. Darcy. Chevy. Has the whole team got a piece of the net? Sherry? Here comes Sherry! Mia! Come on, Sherry. Ladies and gentlemen, Susie. Well, folks, come and join us at the RSL right now. We'll see you all there. Autographs are plenty. And again, Sunday morning at Cotter's Market, 11 a.m.